guys, still there. It's time to try out one of these new maps, and I'm currently on, jeez, I'm not even sure what it's called. It's one of those new ones with the reactor thing in the middle. I'm going to move up into that reactor position with my infantry, which is going to start with an SASR, let's say, advanced party, combined with some RBS-70s, because it's a 10v10 and there's quite a few airborne troops on the other team. Once those guys have landed, I'm going to also bring in my, let's see, Elite Commandos 90 installees, as well as some AA. Because as mentioned, if and when those vehicles carrying airborne troops actually get there, I'm going to need to have some fire support. Now I'm using a ANZAC Motorized deck. It's pretty much my quick strike deck, by which I mean that it's focused on pushing in quickly, getting in damage, and being very, very mobile. Of course, it's not as mobile as a deck like an airborne deck would be, but still, this thing can shift pretty nicely. I'm also going to go with one recon or one support healer, a bushranger. These things do have a few rocket pods on them, not really anything that can damage infantry, but that's what I got the twin miniguns for. So hopefully this small attack group is going to be able to capture a position up front, whereas my infantry, my wheeled infantry, let's say, is going to take quite a while to get there. And by the looks of it, I got quite a bit of support. Got Mr. Radical, a bearded bear, and myself going towards the middle, so that should work. Alright, let's head north. Sangha's going to capture that one, Hornet's going to go there. I got a CV to spare, so why not? Sent the rover there instead. Now, it's not a tactical game, but the game apparently thinks I have so little income that it says plus zero, which is not really accurate, since the income is actually a little under 1 point per second. I'm considering blocking off one of these bridges with a napalm bomber so that the enemy infantry is going to have a harder time getting here. But I think that this might turn into a meat grinder, so I'm instead going to bring in some mortars. They're going to take at least 2 minutes to get there anyway. A couple of patriots moving up from Hornet. There's a bearded bear with his Lynx AH-1. That's British. Let's see what his plan is. Seems to be offloading in front of the reactor there. Surprised that Chinooks are actually this fast. I thought they'd be a bit slower. Oh, we got enemy helicopters coming in. We may need to offload these guys a bit early. I'm very, very glad I flew in AA infantry here. Let's get in the building. Yeah, it would be nice if those helicopters not decided just to park there. Come on. Offload and get out. This second Chinook is having a hard time putting itself down there. Okay. So I have SCSR, we have SCS, we got UDTs, and there's the reinforcements. Ooh, we're taking a bit of artillery fire there. Is it going for me or for something else? Let's see if I can take down that Akula. I have a range of 2800. No, I doubt it. Oh, they pushed in quick here. Yeah, I can scratch that CV. Interesting move, pushing into November as far as they have. And I got absolutely nothing to defend that CV. So he's completely screwed. Yep, bye bye.
Roger, sir. On our way.
We got LSTRs. Oh, interesting. LSTRs are pretty damn good at dealing with enemy infantry. Which in this case is my infantry.
Heading to demonstrate range.
And they also have AA, so I gotta put my bush ranger a bit further back. Let's use the ASLAV here. I cannot focus on two areas here at once. Okay, Stollies. Capture the positions. And get out. RBS-70 is engaging a helicopter there. And they missed it. Come on, you gotta do better than that. Multiple targets popping up. I think we're gonna need a few more of those. Really have enough missiles on these guys. Kill. Missed. Yeah, they're running out of missiles fast. At least those LSDRs are dead. Okay, now make good on this terrain that I've gained. Try to get these guys out. As well as get the repairs in. Sokols, BTR-80s, that means autocannon fire. Emeralds have a range of only 700, that's not that great. Let's bring in a Chinook. My SASR took a bit of damage. Still have to get used to how the supply lines work here. I don't know really what roads the enemy or what my vehicles really are taking. Come on, get in the building, quickly. Oh shit, Spetsnaz. Something I don't really have an answer to. Other than autocannons. So offload those and get out. My Vickers might be able to help out here. Not against the T-55, though. Ooh, that was one Spetsnaz squad. Well done by the Emeralds. Gotta get these Stollies a bit further back. Actually, they have to get all the way out there. I was hoping that they were packing something along the lines of a machine gun, but they don't even have that. Good thing that these things are amphibious, though. Quite a lot of units there. Don't really have too many forces left. It's another, I think, red fort. Where is it? Oh, it's a blue fort. It's one of my guys. Why? Like to see up close, it's from Moses. My Chinook's there. Maybe the Vickers can take care of that tank. If they get a decent round into it. Hurting. Trying to get some more CSR in here. Alright. Colonel Gustav, target down. Let's get the ASLAV in here. Get some other one down. Okay, let's get the Chinook out of there for now. Good kill. Firing and moving along. Oh yeah, still a few FJBs up there. I'm trying to panic or stun whatever's out there. Now I'm gonna set up a sort of taxi service here. Get the vehicle, or get the infantry offloaded into my main compound here. And then use helicopters to fly them across, because the alternative is not that good. Jesus. It's three BMPTs. Bye bye, Migs. Not my kill, but I'll take it. I don't really care who killed them. It's just that I don't want to see three BMPTs up close. It always comes down to the infantryman and his wife. This thing took a massive hit. Let's get him towards the Chinook to get repaired. Alright, reinforcements have arrived. This will take me a bit of extra micromanagement, but it also means my troops are going to arrive much faster and safer. Also, I'm going to need another Chinook. But that's not a Chinook, that's a Mankati. Chinook. Here's the BMPT. Look at the damage that monsters can output. Come on. Got one down. Okay, they're good to go. Somewhere along the edge there, offload and fly all the way back. Now the other flank here, the Emperor. Yep, we got him. He's dead. That he's, I think, at least two of them. Maybe more. Looks like we got decent control over this area now. Well, actually. Let me correct that. Not with 30 spats as it is built. AA is not great against enemy aircraft, especially helicopters or fast flying airplanes. Alright, time to get the Aslav involved. 60 Commandosi. Jesus. The MRO can get a good shot in. At least a little bit. Need help on the right. How bad is it then? Oh yeah. Yeah, that's not good. Maybe we'll just snipe one of those tanks with a Kahu, but I did see a pretty hefty AA piece up there. Get a Kahu on standby. First of all, we need eyes here. 264B, what kind of fire is he taking? None, by the looks of it. Oh, snap. That was one mortar down, probably two. Yep, there's definitely AA there. I have here is going to have to try and hold while I deal with the other flank. Yeah, I lost all my mortars. Damn it. Let's go with an SLF 25 to spot stuff. Now, they have quite some heavy vehicles, they got quite a few transports. What we mostly need right now is reconnaissance, because that tank's blind. As far as points goes, we're looking at pretty balanced. 300 points apart. Not worried. Oh, I lost my SAS on. Shit. These guys are pushing in quite a few heavy vehicles without knowing what they're going for. That's very, very risky. FJBs against commandos. My money's not on the commandos in this one. MRAs to push back north. Come on. Help him out. Great, the next building is quite far away. Gotta take down that thing right now. Before he's gonna get into our city. Okay. His position is not exactly as strong as I thought it was. Get the Kahu out of here. Look at that, Spetsnaz, Kodosi, or Skyas. I don't think that I'm able to hold here. Might be safer to pull back. Because I'd hate to get all my troops killed off there. That's left empty. Vickers. Sorry for my allies, but I'm gonna have to do a bit of cleaning on the right flank first. Get in the Chinook. Where are my rides? They're still coming in. Damn. Ooh, that was an expensive tank. Gonna get the F-111 on standby. I need to defend that thing. So much for my escape plan. Aslav and Vickers are both... yeah, they're amphibious. So we have to get the hell out of here with those things. The rest of them are pretty much in trouble until my stollies float across. K-52. Something with extreme range against helicopters must be a tractor up here then. The problem is I don't really know how good their AA is here. But if we let them push in, my ally's gonna get flanked here, Critical Bear. I'm gonna try and bomb those Spetsnaz. It's coming in from that flank. Say somewhere along this vector. Bombs out. Some response. He's popping flares. He's not hit though. Oh, that got me a lot of points. Looks like they were pushing up. That's interesting. Make 31M. It's Dungushka, is that? Yep, it's still up. Right. For now, they're not pushing up on that flank. Suits me just fine. Let's see how the Spetsnaz like to get burned. Wow, that almost killed all of my commandos there. Incredible. Here comes the bombs. Ooh, AA response. should give those Spetsnaz something to think about. As they're gonna come out, they're gonna take a lot of fire from my vehicles here. 35 down. Seems to be a bit of a standoff here.
Setting up a new AA position there.
Nobody's really capable of moving anywhere. I did lose my napalm. Look at that. The Vickers and the Aslav took out pretty much all of the Spetsnaz. Yep, they took out all the Spetsnaz. Here's my resupply Chinooks. Let's get those things up. Still have a few pretty much healed up infantry units. Oh, they died. I'm getting smirched. Isn't that nice? Get the Stollies parked in the middle there. The thing's just parked. Ish. It's parked up high though. Okay. Let's do the old mortar trick, trying to shoot those things down. Because right now, the enemy seems to be in pretty much full control of that middle ground there. We're doing 8 versus 8, so that looks decent. That's MTLBV, by the looks of it. Keep that Abrams safe. Hornet does have his own chaparral there. Get some reconnaissance units in there. Thinking a Stolly with some standard infantry. Maybe an Aslav TOW 2 in order to deal with long range targets. Push in. Ooh, I believe that's the long range Chinese thing. And that is a resupply chopper.
Need some extra firepower.
Let's mark that properly so we can try and engage it. I think it's my Aslav that's doing the spotting here.
What are you ordering up there?
Seriously, don't do that if you want to live. Things zipping around quite nice. Let's see, get some RBS-70s up there. I gotta try and get that KA-52. Unfortunately, my mortars are still on the move. How far along are you guys? Not far enough. Now, the thing I don't really like about these mortars is their range. They have a range of 4.9 clicks. Just too bad, but at this range, it's just not nearly enough. This is going to be AA position pretty heavily. Gentleman on the right, attack. Yeah, right. I'm a motorized deck. I'm not really that good at attacking across open grounds. But if I can get my infantry in there, I at least have a decent fighting chance. So let's get a few Stollies ready. I can smoke them with my own mortars if I have to. Here comes my recon Stolly. Or my... what are these guys again? Yeah, the ANZAC. Those must be the guys that have been shooting at my aircraft as they came over.
What is it you want now?
Oh yeah. Here goes. 64, ZTC 85-3. Yeah, they got some expensive units up here. HQ-7s. Hornets pushing in with Marines. Just don't want to get too close to the tanks though. Provide fire support, but not get myself killed. Ooh, they know they're there. Get in cover. Yeah, we're good. Okay. Oh, come on. Mortars are just outside of reach. There's the SLF tube too. I'm gonna need that thing right now in order to deal with some of these tanks. Let's see if we can shoot some mortar rounds into the cockpit of that thing. It's almost dead anyway. And it's moving, of course. Whoa, whoa, whoa. That's not what I was looking for. Lost one SLAF-25. It's just a fire support vehicle though. Not really anything too severe.
There are two types in this world, artillery and target.
Come on, shoot it down. Yep, you got it. Good job. See if my NZs can find something else. Yep, that's the long-range AT platform. And that's an HQ-7. See if I can do anything about that. Now smoke that position, get the Stollies ready to move in, as well as some SLAVs. Alright, here goes nothing. Let's move in. Get the infantry offloaded there. And then try to clear out those HQ-7s. Also, when these things are done firing, they have to move. Need more SLAFs here. Oh yeah. They were kinda waiting for me. Lirenz. Chaparral's in there before we actually clear the position. Unless you don't mind losing those. Oh, I have a lot of recoilless rifle jeeps, which can be really effective against infantry. Helicopter rush right flank. Still have my tractor pier up there. Jesus, there's tanks there. Really do a lot against tanks. Range. Those guys are good as dead. Line of sight here is terrible for these SLAVs. Lead goose surrenders. Looks like a hostile. Tow away. Tank down. That's how I like to see it. Oh, not in range. Come on. Appear in the air. Missile missed. Yep, he's down. Still got ZTZs up there. Let's go with another SLAF 25 tow. Good push here by Pontifex. Lots and lots and lots of vehicles up there. Oh, I still have troops there, but not really interested in risking those just yet. It's got some vehicle support here, as well as a Vickers.
Spotted something?
Hang on, we first gotta take down that helicopter. It's just carrying a lot of rocket pods. But it's still a threat.
Anything for us, sir?
Position. Oh, come on. Damn, it doesn't have good upside. Look at those jeeps go down. Look at that. At least it's wasting its ammo on some cheap units instead of my infantry.
Setting up a new AA position there.
Alright, let's try to rush in. Ooh, three setup of books. Hornet's seen it too, by the looks of it.
Okay, what's the situation?
Yeah, something again took out that jeep.
Looking for a taxi.
There's the Vickers, and there's the helicopter. Get these guys offloaded right now. The terrain is terrible for AA units. Stollies, Lirens. That's what might have taken out the other infantry, or the jeeps that I sent in there. So I think I killed off the tank that was hiding out there. Oh. Missile, got it. That's one down. Go for the next one. Luzandui, missed. Next missile, missed. That's why I never use one of these. I only miss all the time. Now, I would love to kill that thing off. It's worth a lot of points, and it's a very, very big threat. Also going to need some fire support. Lost an S-Life PC. Come on, get in cover. Whatever kind of cover you have. Oh, that's not good. Let's press that position. Shit. Here comes the AA Stolly. Oh, my tractor beer. Shit. These guys seem to have quite the idea of what they're doing. Hold. T-64B's right flank. Yeah, we're gonna abort here. I'm gonna need tanks. I don't have those in my deck. Best I can muster is the AS-1. 16 frontal armor. Sorry, 8 frontal armor with a punch of 16. T-64B is gonna look at that and laugh. I'm doing some damage, but not nearly enough. Surprised that these things made it out alive. How are we doing, little? Looks not too bad. HQ-61A radar guided long range AA platform. Let's try to spend some more points here. Chinook should be able to land some forces there. I'm actually considering flying around with a heli here, trying to do some damage on Echo in November. Those things took a beating. That's a tank. Couple of Phibos flying over. I don't think I have a proper interceptor to deal with that. Nope.
Not my war.
Are they pulling back or what? What is the game plan here? We're doing 12,000 to 9,000. And clock's on 6 minutes. I doubt they're gonna win this. I really doubt it. Let's have that thing hold fire. If he engages that transport, he's good as dead. What are you? Oh, it's D-64.
Someone need a guardian angel?
Interesting. I'll be able to snipe that with a Kahu. 70 points. It's not really worth that much, but it works. Send a bomber to that. Actually, not the F-111, let's go with a Hornet. Hornet's plenty to kill that one. Kahu. Target right there.
Need some extra eyes there.
And you got sniped. No AA responses by the looks of it. Kula seems to be pushing in. I really want to invite that thing to come over here. Oh, it has different plans, it seems. Where's that Kula? It's probably hunting down my AS-350, trying to counter that. And it might very well get away with it, too. With all this terrain, it's hard to get a good line of sight anywhere. Just need to bait that thing into coming after me. WZ-550. CTZ-83. There it is. That's the Akula. And it seems to have spotted up my recon helo. Coming after it. Come and get me. I got a surprise waiting for you.
It always comes down to the infantryman and his rifle.
Come on.
Need some extra eyes, sir.
Oh, they're just getting a lock. Missiles away. Hit, kill. Got him.
Just spotted something?
Very nice. He completely fell for that. Let's do a double Kahu run. Take care of those units. Not that expensive, I think, but anything goes. Oh shit, they lost sight. Yeah, they're screwed. TY-90, hovering high? Yeah, it's hovering high, great. That thing's hovering low. Might be able to kill that with a Hornet. Oh! Maybe he wants to try again. Which would suit me just fine. Now that was an impressive angle on the missile, but it was never gonna hit. Hornet made it out without a scratch, though. Which is nice.
Recce ready, sir.
Yep, he's engaging my AS-350. We're trying to. Yep, he hit it once. Z-5s. 2 minutes left on the clock. I'd hate to lose that recon. Now, if only these things were a bit faster off-roading. Come on, 35. 64B, let's just snipe that then. Good push here, by the way. Pontifex, he's looking at 1900 points. Well done.
It's gonna rain down on them crawlers.
This is one of the few reasons we're actually still here. Trying to snipe that Kahu. Not the Kahu. The 264 is down. Yeah, I'm taking some return fire, but not too bad. That must be HQ 61. Radar guided. Hornet's gonna bomb that helo. These guys are coming up close. Hornet got hit bad. He's down. Just outside of range. But maybe with two Hornets I can take down the K-52. That might work. Shit, I'm gonna lose that helo. Damn it. What the hell? Stealth on that thing is incredibly good. He just had no idea he was being shot at. Lost one Hornet. Shit. Yeah, well, in 14 seconds, I doubt he's going to do anything very drastic there. And that's it. Time's up. Let's see. Ooh, that's not too good. 1600 points gained, 1485 lost. 0 command points because I lost that CV early on. That's pretty bad. At least I made positive, but I was hoping for something a bit better. Now, I'm wondering what exactly got killed by... Yeah, there you go, F-111. Commandosi, 3 Spetsnaz, 2 more Commandosi, a Ural, and 1 more Sky Escort. That was one bombing run. That was good. Now how's Pontifex? How did he do? Very nice. Well played. And the other guy, Hornets, he was close, but he held the flank there for us. It looks like I still have some ways to go on this map. I still gotta learn where the positions are, and I was moving around from flank to flank a bit. Going from the middle towards the right flank may have been the right idea, it may not, I'm not sure. But I think that between the two of us, we did keep that flank reasonably well. Could have done better. Anyway, let me know what you think of this new map. I think it's called 3 Mile something. I just call it the reactor map. Anyway, looking forward to seeing your comments. Hope you liked it. If you did, please hit like. And if you want to see more Wargame, I'm trying to upload a video every day. So just subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And I'll see you in the next video.